Hi everyone. I know that it's early, but I thought I'd pop on because I am going to set myself a challenge of a workout a day for the next 3 weeks minimum. So every day I'm going to work out, and I thought that I would share my journey with you. And if you want to join in with me, then please do. This morning I'm going to work out and do some supersets using a kettlebell. Okay, you don't have to look at that. I've got nail paint on my nails from painting last night. You don't have to use a kettlebell. You can have some tin soup, use some tins from your cupboard, just grab two. You only need them light, especially if you're just beginning with a weight. Just something light. If anything, you could even do this without a weight and do it body weight. And just really feel that mind to muscle, and really feel the muscle working, connect and stay there with it. But yeah, I'm going to get straight onto it. So my kids are still asleep, so I'm going to be quiet. I'm not going to be shouting like my normal HIIT workouts. But yeah, I'm going to post this on the Facebook group too, so that it can be available for anybody whenever they need it throughout the next few weeks. So yeah, I'm gonna get straight into it. Please make sure you've warmed up, and yeah, we're gonna get straight onto it. So two cans, okay, so two kettlebells, two small dumbbells will do as well. So these are supersets, so we're working from one move straight onto the next. So we're gonna start with a squat and bicep curl. So normal technique for your squat, chest lifted, shrug your shoulders back, your weight's just down nicely, and we're just going to go quite a wide squat, okay, and we're going to go down into the squat, up, and then curl. So I'm going to do this for 12 goes, so that's 11, I'm going to keep going, 10, that's it, chest lifted, 9, nice work guys, weight in your heels, 8, 7, nice wide squat on that, 6, stance, 5, keep pushing, 4, loading those muscle groups, targeting and isolating, 4, 3, 2, well done. So next one, I'm going to pop my weight down and just have one in my arm. I'm going to go and pop my arm out for balance, okay, on this one. We're going to have a wide stance again, okay? And we're going to put one arm up in the air with your bell, pull it down and reach down to your feet. That's it. So that was one. Two. You should really feel that in your core too. Three. Don't be shy from using weights. Four. I'm going to count. Five. Six. Well done, guys. Seven. Eight. Keep pushing through. Load those legs. Nine. 10, come on, 2 more, 11, I don't know if I count forward, 12, last one, yeah, well done. So the superset is working constantly with literally just seconds between your rest, so just switch your weight, and we're going to put the opposite arm out for balance, okay? Raise one weight to the sky, and this is our first one, okay? Wide leg again, and then we're going to go down. Two. Three. Eye gaze to where you're going. Four. Oh, well done. Five. Keep pushing. Six. I wonder if I can get these out before my kids wake up. Seven. Eight. Ah, well done. 9, I'm really loading my legs. 10, 11, In you go, careful. Last one, 12. Well done. Okay, we're gonna go back to that squat, okay? It's really important that you watch an instructor or a video. Don't just make up the supersets on your own, just because it's really important to have a little bit of rest time between working certain muscle groups. So it's good to do biceps, then triceps, okay? So alternative muscle groups. So we're gonna go back now, because we've rested from that squat, doing our lunges. So we're gonna go back to doing that squat. And bicep curl. Yeah, you got it. So all the time, two, that is. Three, I'm counting up to 12. So we're doing 12 reps. Four, well done. Five, that's it. I'm making sure my technique's right. Six, seven, I'm sinking right into that lunge. There you go, my chest's lifted, my core is tight. Eight, I might skip a few, but it's fine. Nine, it's fine, it won't hurt. 10. If you can sense it, that I'm skipping and that I'm missing a beat, then that's fine, you're counting your own time. 11. Last one, guys. Pull on that core. 12. Well done. So, I'm sweating already. So, we're going to do those leg lunges again. Like I said, now that we've rested, just pop one team down. Pop your arm out for balance, that wide leg stance again, and then we're going to raise one arm up, and then we're going to go down into that lunge. Are you ready? So one, chest lifted, I'm piercing through, two, my core, okay, I'm keeping everything locked tight, I'm working the fronts of my muscles here, okay, my thighs now. In that squat, we were working our bums, and now, we're transferring to the fronts of our legs. I'm gonna go with 8. 9. Yeah. 10. Come on, 2 more. I know it's hard with that weight. There you go. Last one. Nice and pull up. Really feel that muscle, that mind to muscle, okay? Don't just throw it about. Really, really think about it. So, opposite arm out for balance, okay? I'm gonna do the same thing again, wide stance. Weight in my heels, my shoulders are rolled back. So let's go. One. Yeah, I'm loading the front of my legs, okay? I can feel it, opposed to the squat, which is the opposite move in this superset. Three. That's it. Four. Don't go chucking your weights around. Nice and controlled. Five. Six. I never like to disturb the kids, so I always try and be nice and quiet. Eight. Come on, pull through. Hopefully this morning I'll have kept it down. And optionally I have my in-ears in. I'm not talking. That's it. Keep going. Keep pushing. Nice and controlled. 10 I'm going to go with. 11. Well done, last one. 12. Awesome. Okay, so bend your knees whenever you're picking up your weights and propping them down. Okay, it's really important to protect everything. So in between sets, you've got enough time for a quick sip of water. And then we get straight back into it. Okay, so that is the last of those sets with the squats and the lunges. So we're gonna go now to a Romanian deadlift, which is with two of our kettlebells or our tins in both hands. Okay, a deadlift is where we hinge from our hips down, we poke our bums back, okay? And we roll our weights down our legs, just past our knees, okay, onto our shins, yeah? So, then we're gonna go up I'm turning my handles on the side, and then we're gonna eye gaze 45 degrees, and we're gonna row. Okay, tricep, row. Okay, so I think that was 4, 5, 6, 7, keeping your elbows in, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, yes, and then we're just gonna sit up. That's brilliant. Okay, perfect deadlift position is with that hinge, straight back but open chest, okay, and with our gaze forward, yeah? Brilliant work. So, the next one, you really do need light weights for this one, so your tins are absolutely fine, and don't go running to the gym for really expensive high weights because you don't really need them. It's just a little bit of tension on your muscles that we're looking for. So we're in that same position. We're in a hinge, but we're not as flat backed, okay? So we're here, okay? Our elbows are tucked in, and then we're just gonna fly our arms out, okay? So, 1, and back down. 2, a slight pause, okay? 3, eye gaze up with your kettlebell. 4, all your weight. 5, 6, well done, slow and control, 7, don't rush this, 8, well done, 9, engage that core now, 10, pause on that uplift, 11, my hands are sweating, 12, well done, all the time on that my bum was poking out, I was engaging my glutes and my core muscles, and also raising, okay, pulling and strengthening my core, which is the major bit about that. Right, okay. So, the next one is a tricep row, which we've just done. We're gonna get straight into it. Like I said, this is a superset, so we're going straight on to the next one. So, a tricep row we've just done. So we're hinging and we're falling. We're bringing our weights all the way down to our shins, running them down. Elbows are in. And then we're gonna tricep row, down, and stand. Okay, back down, row, and stand. That was 2. Okay, row, and stand. Well done. So rolling it all the way down. 4. Well done, slow and controlled. 5. Well done, guys. 6. On that uplift, you can really sense the pull in your core, okay? So keep everything tight, or your elbows nicked in. Well done. 8. 9. Roll it down, slight bend in your knee. 10. 2 more, guys. 11. That's it. And last one. 12. Ah, well done. I'm sweating now. Okay, so we're gonna go with the next one is a chest press. Okay, I've got everything wrote down just so that I don't forget it, but I am. No, tricep flow. So our next one is tricep flow. So we're gonna go down and we're gonna do this with the row. Up into that standing position and then bringing it up and then back, reversing that flow. Okay, so we're bringing a new sense to it, okay, and we can flow quickly with it only when you're comfortable. Okay, do it in stages. We're a bit robotic really when it comes to weights. And we fly it back over onto our shoulders, back down onto our, keeping our elbows nice and tight, guys. A nice bend in the knees, pulling it forward, and we're gonna row into the flow. That's it. Nipping those elbows together, down, nipping them into your side. And I would say that this is number 5. Yeah? That's it. Perfect. Well done. 6. Well done, you've got it. And back down. 7. Whoop. That's it. Perfect. Get into the flow of it. Your arms should be tiring. And down. Big tricep. That's it, row. Up solid. Bring it down in front of you. Oh, my hands are sweating. And 10. So 10. I'm gonna go for it. That's it. If you can get into the flow, then do it. Might come a bit more the rhythm. Last one. Well done. Okay, so I am absolutely sweating off of that one. So by all means, you can double back and do this set again, but just for your first couple of times, the first time you're getting used to the weights and whatnot, just take it easy and do something like this to get you started. So the next one is a chest press, and then we're going to do some abs, okay? So I'm going to actually use both of my weights in this one. Okay, hopefully you can see me down here. So my back's flat to the floor, my shoulders are too. And then we're going to go up with my feet and up with my hands, okay? And then I'm going to bring my hands down beside me, okay? And I'm going to push as in a chest press. And then use my core to get my legs down and back up. And then we're going to do our hands again. Okay, so we're going to do 12 of these. That's it. 3. Well done. 4. This is hard work. Try not to arch your back. 5. 6. And keep it going. 7. A nice big push. 8. 9. Keep pushing. 10. Oh. So if you are arching your back, don't go so low. Okay? That's it. 11. Last one. Well done. Oh gosh, guys, I'm sweating to death. So that is a superset strength, okay? So using some weights, it's been brilliant to get up and get started. It was a quick 15, maybe 20 minutes, I think, maximum 20 minutes. And it is a beginner's, so I hope that you enjoy it, watch it, and just get used to the weights, get used to the movement, just like I have this morning, and see what is in store for the coming weeks. Thanks for letting me share with you guys.